A Little Transistor and Diodes Sam Atari Here.
As I told you in my previous video, I found this project on a popular electronics magazine of the past that was published here in Italy. This is a very famous magazine in Italy. As you can see, I have the copy in my personal collection. We have seen the circuit in the last video, and I think that are not necessary more explanation about the circuit. What I want to show in this video is the functioning and the use of this tester. Because if you read the magazine, there are some errors that were corrected in the next issue of the magazine. So to simplify your life, I will tell you now how to use the tester correctly, so you can ignore the wrong description of the use that you find in the magazine. The table shows the combination of lamps on and off that indicate the condition of the component under test. For PNP and NPN transistor, you have to respect the use of the connection on the front panel. If the lamp 1 is on and the lamp 2 is off, the transistor is good. If you have a shorted transistor, all the lamps will be on, because the transistor will be able to conduct in the two senses. If all the lamps are off, the transistor is open. So the bad transistor are the one underlined with a red line. Now we look at some tests of bad and good devices. To test transistor, the switch on the front should be on the TR position. This switch opens here and leaves at the current a path through the lamp. The switch will be closed when we want to use the Zener test section of the circuit. So we want to avoid that the current flows through the lamp and we give a shorter path. First of all, we test an NPN transistor. This is a good NPN transistor. As you can see, lamp 1 is on. This is a short NPN transistor. The two lamps are on. This is an open NPN transistor. Everything is off.
A little transistor and diodes Sam Atari here.
The same apply for PNP transistor. All you have to do is move the connection in the PNP facility. For SCRs, silicon control rectifier, you have to position the silicon control rectifier on the NPN exit of the front panel. And, as you can see, the silicon control rectifier have the same indication of a transistor. So, if you think at the construction of the silicon control rectifier, you can think at this as a NPN transistor. The TRIAC will be a little tricky, because, as you know, the TRIAC can conduct in the two directions. You have to put the TRIAC connecting to the NPN exit of the instrument, and you have the two lamps on if the TRIAC is good, and the two lamp off if the TRIAC is open. You can test the diode on the collector and emitter connection on the front panel from the NPN transistor, the anode on the collector and the cathode on the emitter. If the diode is good, only the lamp 1 will be on and lamp 2 will be off. If the diode is short, the two lamps will be on. This diode is short because the two lamps are on, connecting the collector terminal to the anode of the diode and the emitter terminal to the cathode of the diode, the current should be flow only in one direction, from the collector to emitter, here in the NPN transistor position, and the two lamps are on. This means that the current is flowing into the two directions, so the diode is short. An open diode, as anything that is failed open, will be equal to the situation when the terminals are not connected to nothing, so the lamps will stay off. If you think that the functioning of the instrument is very simple to understand when the lamps are on and off. In fact, if you short the C and E collector and emitter terminals, the two lamps will be on. And when you don't connect nothing on the terminals of the instrument, you'll have the two lamps off because all is open. My implementation differs from the original for a simple variant. I have added a neon lamp to indicate that the main voltage is connected. I do this wiring a neon lamp 270k ohm resistor in series to limited current, because I don't want to forget a homemade device connected to the main voltage. Check my other video about neon lamp to understand this. We never know what can happen. The Zener tester part of the circuit, we can test the Zener as a diode in the front panel if you want to identify the voltage of an unknown Zener. Instead of building a circuit with a resistor and something else and your tester to know the voltage of the Zener, you can test the Zener here. Just put cathode and anode in the appropriate position of this tester, just refer to the circuit, and rotating the potentiometer here, we are increasing the voltage on the collector of tier 1. When the Zener reaches the breakdown voltage, the voltage will not rise anymore. You can read this value on an external multimeter or, like here, on an analog instrument. Some word on the components. Don't worry about this transistor. You can use any NPN transistor. There is no meaning on the amplification characteristic of the transistor. You have an indication to use an instrument such as this with a 25 volt full scale deflection, but you can use your multimeter, so you don't have any problem to find this. Any component here is not so critical. You have to use two 6 volt 50 milliampere lamps. Do not use lamps with a bigger voltage for a simple reason. You want the lamp to be bright even if the current flowing is very low. Only this you can identify leaky transistors. There is space for some improvements in this such a little and simple instrument. You need a transformer with a center tap, whose transformer that not exceed a 10 plus 10 volts on the secondary. This is not a mandatory rule, but that you don't want to break transistor applying to them a reverse voltage too high.
A little transistor and diodes cemetery here.